National Security Analyst Julia Kayyem, Military Analyst Colonel Cedric Layton, and CNN political commentator and former Congressman Jack Kingston. Welcome to the program, one and all. Mark, it seems pretty clear that the White House is trying to disown this foreign national security, the former national security advisor, but it's not going to fly, is it?
No, and we don't actually know how intertwined it is right now, and that's what the investigation is for. But the fact of the matter is they are very much ensnared in this because he held such a high-profile role. And quite frankly, with the top-secret clearance that he had, and him not only misleading, at least it appears, what his speech was to RT and how much money he made and what have you, or at least that's what we're led to believe from congressional investigators, he also misled Mike Pence, which eventually led to his dismissal from the White House. So the White House is ensnared in this. They're very much tangled up in it. It's certainly going to take a few months, you know, if not longer, for this all to be untangled.
Colonel Layton, you know Michael Flynn. You served under him. What do you think about these new allegations that he may have broken the law?
Well, it's a huge disappointment, Don. And the real big thing here is that, you know, when you're in the military, and especially when you're in the intelligence business, you have a lot of high standards to uphold. And when someone fails or is alleged to have failed to meet those standards, then you have a real problem. And it's from that standpoint that I'm very disappointed. And I also think that there probably is a lot more information to come out on this.
So, Colonel, he filled out the security clearance from about a month after the trip to Moscow, where we saw him sitting with Vladimir Putin, by the way. Can you think of any reason why he wouldn't have disclosed that?
Not at all. In fact, any little thing, I remember, you know, when I filled out my forms, I had friends in different parts of the world. I made sure that the investigators knew exactly who those people were, what their addresses were, and what my relationship was with them. And it's not that hard to do. It's just it's good to be open about this stuff. And apparently General Flynn wasn't.
Yeah, Juliet, Flynn was paid $45,000 by RT. He sat with Vladimir Putin. He got $500,000 from a Turkish lobbying firm. Wouldn't the White House have turned up that in their vetting or no?
Yes. I mean, by a Google search. So the White House will claim likely that they don't do vetting outside of what DOD or whoever was holding his security clearance did. But these stories about Flynn's relationship with Russia in particular, but there was also Turkey, were appearing by mid-2016. So it's not like, you know, when he becomes national security advisor a couple months later, that there should have been a surprise about some of his affiliations. So the person doing the review, let alone the White House counsel's office, would have known and been aware of the omissions. And just to pick up on what the colonel said, people outside the national security field should not believe that this is like onerous oversight, you know, that, oh, he just forgot. This is part of our blood in terms of who we are in the national security clearance process and disclosing every trip we make, even if we go to Ireland with our family or we have a friend who works for a foreign government. This is a part of, you know, it's sort of no different than a doctor having to, you know, take an exam. This is who we are. And so there's the idea that this was anything but a clear intent by Mike Flynn just has to be ignored. He has been in the business for too long.
Yeah, an omission, right? At the very least, it was an omission, but yeah. Jack, Representative Chaffetz and Cummings asked the White House for documentation related to Flynn, and here's part of what the press secretary, Sean Spicer, said about it today.
Then they asked for documents prior to January 20th. As you know, through the Constitution, we didn't assume the White House until January 20th at noon, so we don't have the documents prior to assuming the White House. And then the third would be they listed for every call and contact that he made, which is an extraordinary number. That's a very unwieldy request.
Okay, so Jack, how can there be no record of Flynn's work during the transition? He was working on behalf of the government. And is the White House saying that the request is too big, or they won't comply on other grounds?
Well, the White House actually has issued a statement that they do want to comply with the House request. Some of it was too broad. I think the list of all his phone calls, for example, maybe the transition committee still has that. Maybe the White House does. But certainly that might take some time to put together. Elijah Cummings, the lead Democrat, has said that the White House is not acting in a way that's being an obstructionist. But, you know, one of the things that's curious is that General Flynn's own lawyer is saying before the Moscow trip, he did disclose that to the defense and, or the, to the national intelligence. I don't know if it was DIA or NIA, whatever the authority might be.
DIA.
And so he's saying he did disclose that. That would have been done, of course, under the Obama administration. Those records are out there somewhere. And I think we could find out real quickly, did he in fact disclose those or did he not?
Colonel, you wanted to say something?
Yes, Don. There are two things here. Yes, he did talk to DIA apparently and say that he had gone on the trip or was going to go on the trip. That's well and good. The problem is, though, that there are other things that he needed to do in order to make it completely legal. He needed to get clearance from not only the Secretary of State, but also the Secretary of the Army in order to actually legally get the money that he received from both a Turkish source and Russian sources. The fact that he didn't do that is, I think, what is troubling the Congressional Committee, and I think that's also where he's in legal hot water. So he may have notified the DIA, but the failure to notify the other entities at very high level, the Secretary of State and the Secretary of the Army, that spells trouble for him.
Mark, do you believe the House is in compliance? That they want to comply with this, the White House?
No. I mean, I don't think so, because I don't think they want to, as we said right at the top, I don't think they want to be any more tied to this than they have to be. And I literally wrote down some of the reasons why they chose not to comply with it. Some of it is in the fact that they say they didn't have the records, but they do go on to say that, you know, that they don't have documents because it predates his role with the White House, but yet he was an advisor on the campaign. And if you are going to run a very tight ship, so to speak, and certainly to have somebody who's going to be helping oversee your national security and help lead that effort, you got to know what they're doing.
Mm-hmm. General Flynn's attorney says that Flynn did brief the defense agency, as Jack said, extensively about his RT trip before and after. He also offered Flynn's testimony in exchange for immunity. I mean, what are the chances of that, Mark Preston?
Who knows? I mean, again, that's where we'll see where the investigation goes. I thought Phil Mudd brought up an interesting point earlier, saying that basically it's not Congress's point to say whether they're guilty or innocent. They're there to investigate. It's up to the FBI. Where there's smoke, there's fire. You know, I do think it's worth saying this, and perhaps the colonel, can attest to it. This is a tragedy. This is somebody who gave his whole life, his career, you know, really achieved, like, a place in our history that very few do as a general, and this is where he is right
very
now.
Very rarefied position. Colonel, I have to ask you another question, though, but if it is found out that he concealed information about his trips and payments and from foreign governments and so forth, how much trouble is Michael Flynn in?
A lot of trouble, Don, a lot of trouble. And, it could point to all kinds of other things that, are right now in the realm of speculation. But, if I were the FBI, I would certainly be looking at not only the failure to report these things, but what actually happened during these trips and what other relationships General Flynn may have had with the Russians or any other foreign entities.
Yeah, we have to end it there. Yes. Thank you all very much. I appreciate it. We come back. Ivanka Trump in Berlin speaking on a panel with female business leaders, but